keeping force, you have come under severe criticism from some quarters that in fact you have been perceived not to really be a peacekeeping force, meaning being neutral between two parties, but that in fact, at least according to some of these sources, rightly or wrongly, perceive you to have played a partisan role, to have taken sides. Do you get the sense when you interact with people on the ground, especially in areas that used to be politically close to Mr. Babu, like in the western part of the country, that people on the ground do retain confidence in your ability to deliver what you are supposed to deliver to them?
I was last week in the West, and I was there as well in February and in January. And when I was there, I met the political and administrative authorities, I met the religious leaders, I met the community people, and I met the displaced themselves. My message has always been the same. There is such a thing as a humanitarian community, which includes the UN and NGOs. This part of the UN is not the political arm of the UN. It is not the peacekeeping part of the UN. As the humanitarian community, we remain impartial, we remain neutral, we remain independent. Our only objective was to help Ivorians in distress, notwithstanding their political affiliation, their religious affiliation, or their ethnic affiliation. In fact, in Dwekwe, one of the women reacted when I was explaining that when somebody comes to support you, to help you, you embrace him with open arms. So people really perceived the humanitarian community as responding to the distress of the population. Needless to say, there are always people not making the distinction, but by far they noticed through our action that the humanitarian community was fulfilling a specific mandate which was different from the mandate of the political branch of the mission in Côte d'Ivoire.